Listen, Anna, listen.
I can't tell
if
people
that. If he was a Muslim, I'll punch him.
All the patriarchs of Ethiopia are African. And the Pope in Rome has been African. You're lying.
What do you think about you, Turkish government, who helped ISIS to join to go to Syria and Iraq? You haven't said nothing.
He would prefer to be homeless in the UK than live in Saudi Arabia.
If you don't want to get engaged in debate, then walk away, please.
But no,
you can't. Wrap up your point, Hatun.
I'm just saying, lady believes jihad is all about dealing with yourself.
Your point is fake. You are just trying.
So you are saying Quran is a fake book.
Improving yourself.
Does
Quran teach us that?
Does the Bible?
She shouts a lot, man. Get
does the Bible teach that?
Does the Bible teach a knife for a knife, sister? Does the Bible teach a knife for a knife?
Or any shape?
Listen.
So, question is simple.
The Bible teaches revenge, fight,
should be
proven. You have heard. Jesus said, you have heard. You have heard. Yes. Jesus said, you have heard. Jesus said, you have heard. And I tell you.
Don't shout.
So, can I just express one point? This Muslim lady who identifies herself as a Muslim.
Yes, thank God.
And then identifies herself, her job
and
as a teacher.
And how you identify yourself? Yes. Because somebody has no knowledge, but you don't.
That
you have no knowledge whatsoever. You tell me.
So?
If you shout that out, it's not you punch him like a pinch.
Religion of peace.
It's
because one of those things are difficult, even though
you
want to be faithful to Islam.
You cannot function.
I will never give you my dead speaker's
belligerent mind. You can't
my brother's sister.
I'm calling the police.
I should call the police. Why not?
For what?
Why shouldn't you call the police?
He didn't touch her.
Yeah, you got the police. Junior, call the police.
Do you think should she punch him?
No.
Where is he? Do you think he should punch her?
Junior, help
her. He shouldn't shout at her.
Why are you shouting at me?
Hey, man. No,
you are
raising your voice.
I need to love you. I need to pray for those who don't love us and who persecute us.
This is insurprise.
Teaching of the religion of Islam.
Okay.
So-called peaceful religion. Right. Muslim woman tells the Christian man, I'm gonna punch you. Every Muslim is silent.
Wow.
Don't you see?
Can I say something about it?
There is a problem in the religion of peace.
Can I say something about it? Okay. You've been talking about killing. My brother, you've been talking about killing violence. But you don't realize majority of the killers, the Muslims who doing the violence in the Middle East, they're all born in Europe. Majority of ISIS, they're all Chinese born in Europe. They've been going to English school, French school, European school. Listen up, my brother.
Just a minute. Let me finish.
There you go. Let me finish. You've been talking for a long time. So you're not listening now.
Yeah, finish your point.
So they've grown up here in Europe. They've been educated in English in European school. And they go English, British, French, American, European passport. They flow from here to Turkey. There's people waiting for them. Take them, train them, and make a violence.
Turkey, huh?
Do you hear it, guys?
What's your point?
The violence, you allow the violence to grown up. There was a cooperation between America and Saudi Arabia to build more mosques and to be with the violence box to get this a new version of extremism to make you defy people to let you from Egypt come in here against me from Iraq against everybody to defy people. But behind all this is a politics. Okay, it's nothing to do with religion.
Sir, what's your name? Sir, what's your name?
My name is Adam Tom Mu'afa.
Okay. So let me respond to that. Can I just congratulate you?
Yeah.
First of all, identifying those people who fight in the name of religion as a Muslim. And Muslim by definition, I am sure you would agree with me, those people who follow the teaching someone called Allah and who also follow someone called Muhammad. It doesn't matter where is their money come from. Important thing is where their ideology come from.
Follow the sport.
That's right.
I haven't finished. I am very grateful that we identify them as a Muslim.
Is that your cameraman?
And he's not identifying them as a heretical Muslims or cults, but as Muslims. Okay. Doesn't matter where they are born.
Important point is they follow
something called Quran, they follow someone called Muhammad.
Yeah.
And Saudi Arabia is so called a country which follows the teachings of Allah.
Can we discuss this point?
Muhammad, check that out.
Can we discuss this point?
My question to you.
No, I need to make a comment.
Can you please tell me actions of ISIS?
Okay.
If there is anything you think discredits the teachings of Muhammad and teachings of Allah.
Can I just comment first before answering your question?
Yeah.
We have to understand the violence is starting after 2003. This is why after invasion of Iraq. This is why the ISIS has been created in that time. But also, too, I need to take you back a little bit to the 1980s when Al-Qaeda didn't exist. By money in my Al-Qaeda. 1998. By funded by who?
Hillary Clinton.
Muhammad.
My brother, please have respect.
Muslims,
can we have respect?
Muslim brotherhood.
Do you think we can have a conversation like
Muslim
this?
Muslim brotherhood.
Can my brother? Funding. Can my brother? Can
funding
I just
them.
Carry on.
Can I just finish?
Defend yourself.
They fund it by who? By America. Listen, my brother.
No. Muslim brotherhood is doing.
Have respect.
Yeah. We got it. Don't worry.
So you can have your turn. Okay?
We got it. Don't worry.
No, but you are
once a time. Once a time.
Uncle, we got it.
Once a time. Once a time. Once a time. We get a chance to talk. So she was coming about this kind of people who is making a violence. It's called ISIS, Al Qaeda, or I'll give you more, Boko Haram in Africa. So that is not by accidentally. It's all they coming from one source. What is called, and you know it. Everybody know what is called that source of teaching. Wahhabism. And Wahhabism is funded by, you making a mistake between the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab is nothing, is a scholar of teaching. So you need to understand when you're telling people about Muhammad, the Prophet, there's a difference between the Prophet and different between the violence man is called Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. And also you know, because you're from Egypt, are you from Turkey?
Egypt.
That's fantastic. That's fantastic.
Egypt.
You're from Turkey. Yeah. Do you know the whole, I would say not all, the majority of ISIS who flew from Europe or Africa, they landed in Turkey airport, and Turkish government, your government, taking them somewhere, train them, and send them to Iraq and Syria.
So let me respond to you now.
So what, let me, you're asking a question, I'm going to ask a question.
Yes.
So what you thinking about this thousands of they landing in Turkey, Turkish government, you government, they helping them, they train them and send them to Syria and Iraq. What are you talking about? What are you saying about that?
So I'm going to first respond. I'm going to pass the ball to my brother because he wanted to comment some of the things you said. Sir, are you listening?
No, they're Muslim, my brother.
He's not.
Are you listening?
Sorry, my brother, let me see one second.
I would love you to bring...
Can you answer my question as well?
So, yeah. Let me respond to you.
Engage in the conversation.
So, I just heard what you said. And I'm very, very disappointed. Even though you try to give a lecture and pretend that this is the Oxford class, yet you fail to answer my question. My question still stands. What are the actions of ISIS? What are the things those followers of ISIS, who also follow religion called Islam, who also follow the teachings of the Quran and teachings of Muhammad, did goes against the teaching of Islam? Give me the top 10 list what they have done which goes against the teachings of
my
Islam.
Sister, we said that
sir,
so many times.
Sir,
can we get something in you now?
Sir,
I'm
so
hearing this
I did not get a response to the question I simply asked. Isn't that sad?
Yeah.
I don't care, as I expressed to you, where the money comes from. I care for the ideology.
I think
it
I
is the
I think
ideology.
I answered your question. Where's that teaching come
dangerous.
From?
Yeah,
teaching doesn't come from the Wahhabis. Yeah. Teaching does come from
Quran and Hadith.
Who?
Who?
Yes.
Come on, guys. You should know by
Quran
now.
And Hadith.
Teaching
your cameraman should be a fair man, not with the one bear man. This is the fucking media. It's an example of the media. Sorry, my sister.
Sir,
example of the media. They always have an agenda.
Stop deflecting. Answer the question.
Please let me respond what you said. Teaching doesn't come from America. Teaching doesn't come from Saudi Arabia. Mm-hmm. Teaching comes from the book called Quran.
Yeah.
And actions and practices are coming from man called Muhammad.
Yes.
Even though this Muslim brother wants to make a case. Muhammad was so peaceful.
My sister, we heard that. Can you answer the question now?
You
said that so many times. I heard it.
Keep point, keep point.
Watch out the Pharisees.
Okay.
Muhammad was not that peaceful. If Muhammad was peaceful, then he changed the definition of the peace. According to Muhammad, his definition of the peace is in 627.
I think she's taking longer than mine.
You
take a longer time than me, my sister.
Take the life of Jewish people.
There you go.
That is the definition of the peace.
Can you answer the question now?
Killing the people
of the book. Can you answer the question now?
Definition of the peace according to Allah, you would chop the hands and feet off people who mischief.
I'm going to answer it.
Can you tell us what the question
ISIS
now?
What ISIS is doing is they are practicing so peaceful men called Muhammad's actions.
Somebody third person tell us answer the question.
I will answer. I have an answer.
They are
not you.
Teachings of the Quran. That is all it is. And he already noticed Muslim brother failed to give me answer. What are the top 10 things ISIS did when against the teachers?
My brother, can you tell us answer the question? Been taking a long time.
And there was no response.
My sister, be quiet.
Oh, okay. Thank you, sister. Thank you.
No, answer. I can't check two.
Answer for your question.
I can't check two. It's not fair. That's not fair.
Answer for your question.
I'm not asking you the question. I'm asking her.
You said.
Here you go.
Here you go.
Here you go.
You said. I will be given a time.
You said.
No. I did ask you a question about your Turkish government helping ISIS to go to Syria. My brother.
Let me respond.
You stop back. If you have nothing to do with this conversation.
Sir,
answer my question.
Don't my brother like that. You already
told him you are going to give him. I said I didn't ask him the question.
You already told him that you are going to give him time.
My sister, I said to him, I asked you the question.
Let me respond. Unbelievable. About the Turkey.
Can you bring somebody intelligent here to talk into? I asked you the question. Okay, fantastic.
Here comes your daddy then. Here comes your daddy.
I'm reminding me, I answered your question.
Come on, daddy.
Another time.
Can you answer the question now?
Yes, I love to answer the question. Yeah.
What's your argument? Here comes your daddy.
Shut up.
This is not a Sharia corner.
My brother, we have a conversation. I asked a question, she asked me a question.
Can you be quiet?
Can somebody tell him to be quiet?
You said, bring some intelligent man. Bring some intelligent man.
My brother, you step off.
He hasn't even said anything.
I asked him the lady.
Hey.
Now, man. You live in England, rather you haven't learned one thing from here.
Rather it is
two people talking at the same time is not acceptable.
Let him finish.
Not acceptable.
No, it's my turn now.
I did ask you a question earlier. You've been talking for maybe 30 minutes. What do you think about your Turkish government who helped ISIS to join to go to Syria and Iraq? You haven't said nothing.
Okay.
Can you answer the question?
Answer. Let her answer then.
I am surprised and disappointed. Even though you did not answer my question,
unbelievable.
It was all right for you to ask me questions. But I'm going to be generous.
That's it.
And I'm going to respond to your question. First of all, please apologize that you accused me being of Egyptian in your time.
Can you answer the question? Unbelievable. I'm here for 30 minutes.
Don't be impatient.
Do you know how to get frustrated when somebody tries to move away? Can you answer the question? What do you think about your Turkish government who helped ISIS? But she's not answering the question.
Well, let her answer the question.
No, you're not Turkish. You're not. I'm Turkish. No, brother, I'm asking her, please.
Answer, please.
Do you have some respect, people?
Answer, please.
I'd love to see how you are going to show your respect as I speak. So, I am disappointed that you are putting me to defend or talk about the actions of the Turkey.
You're not even listening.
You've just lectured us about respect when she's trying to give you an answer.
You don't even listen.
Exactly. What's the respect there, bro?
Take the plank out of your own eye, brother, before you start taking the respect out of someone else's.
Yes, man. Yes.
Sorry,
hey,
Hatton.
Do you want to hear the answer? Come on.
Okay.
Big up, man, like you.
Hatton.
I am assuming, why are all those followers of Islam who follow the book and follow the teaching of Muhammad?
Fucking hell, answer the question!
You're just not listening.
You're not answering the question!
That's your name, lady. Your dean has told you.
Why are you swearing at a lady?
No, we've been talking.
Where's your manners?
My brother. We've been talking. You just arrived.
No, but
you just arrived. She's been asking me so many. My brother. She's been asking me so many questions. I answer it. But you're not answering the question.
Can you please say,
you're not even listening, bro. That's the thing. You're not listening.
God end of the sentence. Exactly. So far, yeah. I just put in the commas, okay?
Of course. Listen carefully. Please answer.
So I can assume that you've already been to Turkey to see where the Turkish government is also claiming to follow the religion of peace, Islam, the Quran and Muhammad, who is so much following.
Here you go on to the Quran and Muhammad.
Interrupt you, look.
She's not answering the question.
She is answering the question.
I'm asking a single question.
I tell you what, bro. Give her 3 minutes without interrupting our time.
I didn't interrupt you. I've been waiting for 30 minutes to get the answer.
I'm not gonna waste my time with someone who failed to bring his ears and his brain to speaker's corner.
That's right.
So this is last time I'm gonna make the statement and I'm gonna walk away because I can see the teachings of Islam, how you are representing it, and at speaker's corner, which is not Sharia corner, it's not acceptable.
Answer to her now.
3 minutes.
I can assume, all I can do is, I can assume that while Turkish government is training the followers of Islam, those people who follow the Quran, those people who follow the teachings of Muhammad, and training them as the fighter for ISIS in the goal of Caliphate to come, in the goal of Islam to come and train. What should I expect? A country who claims there is only one version of Islam, that is the teachings of Muhammad and teachings of Quran, and they simply want to support that, sir. Why do you want me to judge that? Why you as a Muslim, you are silent. While as a Muslim, you do not even condemn the teachings of actions of ISIS as a cult or as a non-Muslim. They follow the teachings of Muhammad. They follow the teachings of the Quran. So, can you please tell me, why Muhammad was so peaceful? Why he killed over 600 men? Why Ali, who you follow, was so peaceful?
Exactly.
Burned people alive. If your religion is that peaceful and the actions of ISIS does not come from the teachings of Muhammad, are you here today to tell us Quran should put to bin? Are you here to tell us teachings of Muhammad should be condemned? That's all I'm asking you, sir. Give me top panties that against the teachings of Islam.
First of all, I need to make a comment before I answer your question. Turkey are a member of Europe. Turkey, let me think, you've been talking, I've been listening.
They're not. Turkey's not part of the EU, though.
You've been talking,
okay. Shall I shut up now?
Turkey
is a bigger friend of America, England, France, and Europe, and everybody. And everybody knows that.
That's right.
No, let me finish.
Listen up. Turkey is a part of what you call it, European defense, whatever.
Element.
And defense. And NATO.
NATO. Turkey is not Arab. Turkey is a claim that are Europe. Also, you're ignoring what I said earlier. I said majority of those Muslims, young Muslim who join ISIS, they all born in Europe. They all have connection. Listen to this. I say for the last 25 years that we have a two fashion state in Middle East, Israel and Saudi Arabia.
Fucking Israel.
This is my brother.
Yeah, okay.
Israel and Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia are the most violent dictator country in the world. And Saudi Arabia funding every single madrasas in extremism. My brother. In the eye, front of eye of America. America told them to fund. For the last 25 years, how many mosques has been building in Europe?
Too many.
How many mosques has been building in Africa?
Too many.
Money of who?
Saudi Arabia.
Does America doesn't know that? I'll give you another example. Statistically, they said more than 100,000 ISIS, they flow from everywhere to Turkey in Jordan to go from Turkey to Syria. Do you think? Yes, that's statistically.
Do you think satellite of America doesn't see those people?
No. America's not got a Christian
constitution. The satellite
constitution.
Can see us now, we're talking to speakers.
America's not got a Christian constitution. Saudi Arabia says that it follows the deen of Islam. That's the difference.
My brother.
That's the difference.
Saudi Arabia is your friend.
Wow. No, Arabia, not my friend.
Listen, my brother.
I'm part of the church.
Listen,
Saudi
my
Arabia
brother.
Is not a friend
brother,
of the
why,
church.
Why stop me? Why, she's been talking. Yeah. You've been listening.
Yeah. No worries, sir. I'm listening.
The prince of Saudi Arabia was here for 3 months ago, bought billion of money.
Mohammed bin Salman is
my brother's, wait.
He's idiot. He killed people.
My brother, please, wait. Million, billion of money he bought a weapon from here. He bought a weapon from America. Is that correct or not?
America's not got a Christian constitution.
No. Where's that woman got
to Christians.
This woman got to hand of ISIS.
Christians
you've been
for the actions in America,
ISIS.
And America doesn't claim to
ISIS.
Be Christian.
Yeah.
But Saudi Arabia
ISIS.
Does claim
we have
to be
to do
Islamic.
With ISIS. My brother, listen, I'm not finished yet. So you're cutting me all the time. You're taking my time. I was listening. I'm from Iraq. Yeah. We have a Christian and Jewish and all other religion live in my country, neighbor to each other. That's the problem right. Starts since 2003 when you invaded Iraq.
Christians were persecuted in Iraq. Saudi Arabia funding you. It's funding this man as well. Second class citizens in Iraq for 1400 years.
I've been watching you guys here for months. I've come from Manchester, yeah?
No, no, it's speaker corner.
Whoa, you're blue already. You're blue already.
Let me finish my brother. I will go farther than that. You said your religion is a peaceful religion. Yes, I agree. But your people, Muslim and Jewish and Christian, that you hijack the religion. We never had a black man running the top of the religion for all of the big religion. Jewism.
One minute.
My brother, wait.
Slavery.
Muslim.
How long was slavery?
All was white man.
That's not true.
That's a truth.
No, that's not true. We had African popes. We've had African popes. The Coptic popes. All the Coptic popes are African. All the patriarchs of Ethiopia are African. And the Pope in Rome has been African. You're lying. You don't know the history of the church.
Which church? King of it? What? You're talking about English church?
The Greek church.
No, let's go to the English church. We're here in Britain.
Let's go.
Let's go to the English church.
Let's go to the conversation.
Turkey,
the most criminal government, Samson Arabia.
You're senior, right?
Yeah, but
there's
I'm
no
arguing
in between.
From facts.
Yeah, but what
he's
then,
arguing
that's
from
that.
Rhetoric.
No, that's not
he's
that.
He's just making
you're
catchphrases.
Being ignorant. You're
I'm talking from
right.
History.
You're taking
that's
what
the difference.
You. No, you're taking what fits your bill.
Right, brother, listen to what he said.
What about my history in 2003?
That there's never been a black man in charge of the church.
Yeah, he said that.
There's never been an African in charge of the church. But for 2,000 years, the Coptic Church is an indigenous African church whose popes were African. The current pope of the Coptic Church is Tawdros II. He's African. The patriarch of the Ethiopian church is African. And the Roman church has had popes from Africa. So his argument might sound like a nice catchphrase, but it's factually ignorant.
Exactly.
And if you're going to argue against the facts, then you need to go away and study.
Can you tell me in your history one black man was the head of a Christian religion in the whole 4,000 years?
Yes, the current patriarch of Ethiopia.
How many?
2,000 years. That church is 2,000 years old. It's a church in Rome.
Before the Romans took over Christianity.
What about women?
When the Romans took over, there was no Romans.
Christianity.
What about women?
The Christians took over the Roman Empire.
What about women?
Get your history right.
What about women?
What?
Women in your religion, Sam is a second class, is Sam's oldest woman, Rabia.
Excuse me! Whose prophet said that the majority of those in hell are women? Muhammad! Who said that women are like fields, go into them and plow them? Muhammad! Who said that the witness of a woman was worth half that of a man? Muhammad! Who said that if you are raped, you need four witnesses! Muhammad!
You go to him.
I don't need to take a lecture from a Muslim about equality between the genders.
Exactly.
By contrast, what did the apostles teach? The apostles taught that there is neither man nor woman, Greek nor Jew, slave nor free, for all are one in Jesus Christ. That's the difference between our two religions.
Can I make a comment about that? This is what he read from Wahhabism source. The first one, let me tell you something, he doesn't know my history. The first, the wife of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, she was a businesswoman. He was working for her. She was paying his wages.
When they were pagans!
You liar!
He worked for her before he became a prophet. And you're trying to claim the equality of pagan Mecca as Islamic. That's a lie.
This is what you're arguing with other people.
That's a lie.
Let me talk. No, you've been talking. Let me say something.
Was Khadija pagan at the time? When they married,
Were they pagan?
They were pagan.
They were pagan. You're claiming the equality of pagan Mecca as Islamic, and it's not. When Muhammad entered and dominated Arabia, the position of women went down, not up.
That's good.
That's a fact.
This is what you're reading about. What you're reading about wrote it 250 years after the Prophet Muhammad died.
I agree.
Listen, my brother.
Listen,
you want to, I know you're reading from Wahhabism source.
Are you sure?
That's my brother. You're reading from Wahhabism source.
Why shouldn't I trust Wahhabism?
Tell me, answer the question.
If you don't allow me to talk, I'll move away.
Tell me. Wahhabism? Because, ladies and gentlemen, the Christian faith, at a time in the Roman period, when women were seen to be simply the objects of men's possession, Christ taught a radical equality between men and women, and so did his apostles. They said there is neither man nor woman in Jesus Christ.
Exactly.
That's what the apostles taught.
You're Christian Wahhabi, my brother.
Mingled with women and treat them with a dignity and a respect that was unheard of in his own time. By contrast, when Muhammad's teaching became dominant in Saudi Arabia, the position of women was dropped. Before, when they were pagans, women could own businesses. After Islam dominated, the position of women decreased. They became something to be kept in the homes. Could only come out if totally covered. Their equality before the law became diminished.
Can I say something?
We Christians don't need to take lectures from Muslims because our faith on this matter is better than theirs. They need to listen to us.
The Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's the best one in the world.
Really?
The Muslim people is the best in the world.
The best in the world.
And the Egyptian.
The best in the world. That's the claim. Islam makes you better is essentially what he said. So it doesn't matter how stupid they are, how ignorant they are, how self-destructive they are just better because they're Muslim. Is that your argument?
Why the Jewish people kill Palestinians?
No, answer the question.
Why the Jewish people
want to change the topic? Ladies and gentlemen, if Islam is so amazing, why is it that the Muslim world wants to live in the West and not the Western world wants to live in the Middle East? I'll tell you why. Because Islam failed the Muslims. That's why. Their civilizations are so bad that even he chooses the West over Saudi Arabia. Even he chooses the West. He would prefer to be homeless in the UK than live in Saudi Arabia. That's why. Because Islam failed the Muslims. You don't see thousands and thousands of Christians running to live in the Middle East. But you do see thousands and thousands of Muslims coming to live in the West.
You live in
Because Islam does not make you better. If you follow it, it makes you worse. And that's a fact. You come cash in the bank.
Exactly.
Look. Come on, Jesus, and he said, bring my enemy in the front of me and kill him.
Answer. Yes, answer.
He said, bring the enemy in the front of me and kill them.
So,
come on, answer.
I'm going to.
Who's a pagan? Muhammad is a pagan. He's insulting his own prophet.
Who's a pagan?
And the Muslims now. He insults Jesus and the Muslims. That is how their dean really is. Because really, in the heart of the Muslims, they only have one prophet. His name's Muhammad. And despite everything they claim to the contrary, they don't love Jesus. Which is why, when a Muslim right now insults Jesus, all the Muslims are quiet. All of them. Because your dean is fake.
Fake.
We are fake, guys.
You think you love the prophets, but you don't. You only love Muhammad. Which is why, when Jesus is insulted by Muslims, you have nothing to say.
Look, Muhammad.
By contrast,
how many God you have?
Muhammad was a stupid man. He was an ignorant man. He was a man who said that if you ate dates in the morning, you would be immune to poison that day.